going on, guys? It's Matt James here. Today I'm going to be walking you through how to get the electric bow into Eisendrache, the latest zombies map.
I know the bow and arrow is key, but to which doors?
We're going to assume we've already got the Wrath of the Ancients bow. And from there you want to head outside into the main courtyard, head up the steps towards the bastion, and shoot the little weather station thing that's spinning around. On the death ray side, a wall will break open and out will fall your pieces of the arrow that you need to start this quest. Now from there you want to head back down the steps towards the clock tower. If you stand just next to the clock tower and look out over the edge, you'll see a little wooden stack. You need to shoot that with your Wrath of the Ancients bow. Once you do this, you'll see that it lights up. There's two more of these stacks to shoot. The next one is on the other side of the bastion. Just walk straight over the other side. Go halfway down the steps, look through the gap again, and you'll see another one. This one's pretty far away and pretty hard to hit. Now, the third one, you're going to need to go back down into the pyramid room, open the teleport doors and jump in the teleporter, teleport to the rocket pad. As you walk out the doors of the rocket pad, to your right, if you look up on the hill, you'll see the third one.
The fate of the world rests on what happens on the moon. I must prevent the inevitable.
Okay, so once you finish that, you want to jump back in the teleporter, head back to the pyramid room. Once you get back to the pyramid room, you're just going to want to wait around until anti-gravity turns on. Then you're going to want to jump up on the wall and wall run the entire perimeter around. There's five plates to hit. You'll hear it every time you hit one, and after you've completed them all, it'll make a certain noise. You won't be able to miss it. I suggest you start from the stairs too when you're wall running. That way you don't have to jump a gap. Once you hear that noise, that means you're done. All the plates should be lit up blue now. You can head upstairs to the clock tower for the next stage. And once you get in the clock tower, just under the wooden stairs there, you'll see some electric lightning looking stuff in a blue pot. You want to hang around that and kill six zombies, and you'll see their souls floating in that pot. There's another two of these pots around the place. I'll show you where they all are. You need to do the same for them to activate them. Now you know you'll finish each pot when you kill zombies and there's no more souls floating out of them. Now the second pot is just across the bastion, back down the stairs past where you shot that second stack, and turn to your right when you get to the bottom of the stairs. You'll be in a little room, you'll see the pot straight ahead, just before the jump pad.
The arrow will...
So now you want to head back up to the clock tower bastion, pop in the wonder sphere there and jump yourself down to the rocket pad. Head inside the doors of the rocket pad, and at the back on your right you'll see the third pot. Now once you're done with the pot, what you want to do is walk up to it, draw your bow right back and hold it. Put your arrow tip on it and it will light up blue. Walk outside to the stack and shoot it. You've got to do this, you only get one shot to do this, otherwise you have to go back in, reload it and do it again. When you get it right and you hit the stack, you'll see electric lightning storming around the fire. Do this for all three stacks, just the same as you did before when you shot them. When you're done, you'll hear a big crack of thunder. You'll head back up the bastion and have a look at the weather station that you shot before to get the broken arrow pieces. There'll be a big storm around it. Walk up to the little storm that's on the ground and hold down X or square if you're on PlayStation. That little storm on the ground will go away. After a minute, an arrow will appear there. Pick it up.
Creativity.
Righto, now you want to take that arrow, head back down to the pyramid room, and on each pillar down the pyramid you'll see a box. You want to find the lightning box corresponding to the arrow that you have. Drop the arrow in the box. You'll see it floating there around a blue glow. Now you need to kill a bunch of zombies around it, and the souls are floating in that box. The zombies need to be inside those steps at the bottom of the pyramid for this to work. It doesn't matter where you stand, as long as the zombies are in that area. When you're done, there'll be an audio cue you'll hear. Run up to the box, drop the Wrath of the Ancients bow into it. It'll disappear into the box, and you'll see a big beam of light shine out of it. After a minute, your new bow will appear. You can start having some real fun. This bow is especially handy for reviving people. You just drop a massive lightning storm around you, and it'll kill every zombie that's coming after you, and you have plenty of time to revive.
This is not my destiny!
That's it for this tutorial, guys. Give it a like, thumbs up, hit that subscribe button. Let us know what you think of the video. I'll see you on the next one.